Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. USGS is reporting 4 earthquakes for the last 24 hours for Elgin, South Carolina, but there's been a lot more. They're trying to tell people that a larger earthquake is not coming, but that is not true. I downloaded 2 different monitors once again. This one here is JSC, and we have an earthquake right here at 14:34 in about 50 seconds. I picked that one because it's the most recent in red, but we got another one right here. Let me make that bigger for you. At 16:35, also not being reported. And there it is there. A very shallow earthquake, and that comes in as a magnitude 1.8, also not being reported. That one would be this earthquake right here. This is the monitor here at the top for JSC, at the bottom for BIRD. These monitors are about 60 miles apart from each other, about 32 miles from Elgin, South Carolina. We have another one at 14:59. It actually looks like 2 separate earthquakes. Again, very shallow. USGS normally puts them together when they're so close, and it comes in as a magnitude 2.12. But if I was to separate the first one, it would be a magnitude 0.92, and then the second one would be a magnitude 1.87. But like I said, they normally put them together when they're so close. You can see how it just kind of rumbles into the second one. So the last one they are reporting is this one right here. At 12:46, they're saying it's a magnitude 2.12. Normally, earthquakes less than a magnitude 2.5, people don't report feeling them. 61 people said they did feel this earthquake, and it was given an intensity level of 3, meaning it was felt noticeably by people indoors, but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing autos rock slightly. I think people are becoming more aware of the earthquakes lately. Said it was a vibration like a passing truck. It was definitely stronger than a 2.1. It comes in as a magnitude 2.91. Another earthquake at 9:48. USGS is reporting that. It's not marked in red, though. They're saying it's a magnitude 1.6. There's a spectrogram and the signature. It was 2.1 miles below sea level. As you know, Elgin, South Carolina, is about 400 feet above sea level. Intensity level 3. It wasn't a 1.6, it was a magnitude 2.2. 8 people said they felt that earthquake. It was felt as far as St. George, it looks like. I'm trying to see if I can get a better location. Reevesville, it looks like. Yeah, 1.6. Granted, this has got a lot of sediment in this area, but it wouldn't have been felt that short of a distance for a 1.6. Elgin, one there. Lugoff actually had an intensity level of 2. That one was at 3:48 a.m. this morning. All right, the next one marked in red. Let's see. 46 minutes after midnight universal time. Let's look at the spectrogram. Yeah, look at that. That was in Lugoff. A magnitude 2.1. Intensity level 3. 53 people said they felt that earthquake. That would have been 8:45 p.m. local time. Looks like as far south as Orangeburg and I can't see a name there. Intensity level 3. Let me bring it back out for you. Let's see. Intensity level 2. Intensity 3, 2. They're not giving the names. But we know it's Lugoff and Elgin's probably over here. Oh, that's Blythewood. Okay. It actually comes in. I really shortened up the seismic wave. You can see here. Yeah, I made it really short. But it comes in as a 2.25. They are really downgrading these. So if I put the seismic signature where it really should be, it would come in as a magnitude 2.70. And that's probably even too short. This next one, they're not even reporting. 21, well, not quite, maybe 40 seconds. 21:35, and it's red on both the monitors. Let me make this smaller for you. You can see it's red on both of them. That one comes in as a 2.52. Let me bring it down for you. You can see it's one of the larger ones. When you compare the size of this quake compared to the other ones. Yeah, 2.52. Let me close this out so you can see. Oh, let me close this again. Okay. Yeah, that's a 2.52. Yeah, I don't know why they did not report that. Yeah, so we got the 2.1 they're claiming at 45 minutes after midnight universal time. Then it jumps down to 14:15. There is no 21:35 that should have been in there. That would have been about 6:21 p.m. yesterday. Yeah, why did they not report it? And again, these earthquakes are all tectonic movement. You can see the sharp points. All tectonic movement. Let me go down here to where I pulled the files recently. Yeah, the plates are moving. It is very obvious that this is an area where it's locked and it's not moving. Tensions being built. I showed you yesterday too how one was a thrust earthquake. It was actually an oblique thrust earthquake, pretty much the same, but where the plates trying to move, northwest, and it's locked. So one side of the fault remains the same. The other side tries to rise up. And that's why you have thrust earthquakes. Looks like we got another small one that just came in. Yeah, it's probably a one or a less than one. Yeah, and you can see this one right here. It's on both monitors. Anyways, yeah, I hope you guys are prepared, because when you have large earthquakes in this area because of the sediment, they're felt over a very large area. And damage from a large earthquake would be over a large area. Some of these larger ones, they've been filling all the way up to the border of Canada and the border with Florida. So if you felt any of these earthquakes, if you had damage, evidently there has been damage, things falling off the walls and off shelves. You might even have cracks in your foundation or the plaster of your walls, things like that. Yeah, get the large things away from where you sit and watch TV or eat. Bolt the cabinets to the walls. Make sure your hot water heater is bolted. Don't have anything over the bed that could fall on your head. And if there is a large earthquake, get off the bed. Get on the floor next to your bed. Put a pillow on the back of your neck. If you're in an apartment complex, yeah, definitely get off the bed and get on the floor next to the bed in case the floor above you collapses. Please, I wish you guys would please all be prepared and be safe. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.